In this video, we'll be looking for pivot table slices. Let's see that. I have some data given here on the screen. I'll show you how to create a pivot table and then how to create a slicer with that. So keep your cursor in the data and you can go to this insert tab and you can click on pivot table. So same thing, it will ask you whether your source data. So source data by default it has selected. If you see the dancing ants, where do you want to paste your data? That's a pivot table. I want to paste in this sheet, in this cell number. I'll click on OK. So that is an empty pivot table right now. So what exactly you can do is, I want to insert some few data so I can prepare for the slicer. So I'll pick up here as name, drag it and drop it. I'll pick up the name here. Yeah. Similarly, I want the sales option, drag and drop it. And I want one more region, column, that is the region in the column headings. So I've got this kind of data, right? This says as row labels and column labels. I'm not able to easily understand what exactly it is. So what I'll do is I'll go to design, go to report layout, and I'll say as show in the tabular format. So now it's sensible name, which says as name and the region. Now, if you want to filter some region, or let's say I want to filter some name. So what you do is you usually go to this name and you can click on this option. And if whatever name you want, you select from here, let's say John, Rita, Nita, whatever you want. So I'll select here and I'll say I want. Yeah, so I want here, let's say John, and I'll click on OK. So I've got the John. So if you want more than two options, so what you can do is you can select Rita, Nita and all the options and you can click on OK. So this way I've got three options, but now it becomes a tedious task to go and filter out all the options. What if I give you some user friendly option to filter the this names? So how do I get it? Keep your cursor in the data and you can go to analyze tab and you can see this option, that is insert slicer. So in this insert slicer, these are the names of the column. With respect to which column do you need a slicer? That means a user friendly option. Right now I'll just take it one. If you want, you can take more than one option. Right now I'll go with the name, click on OK. So now if you see, these are the names of the which are present in this list, right? So now what I'll do is I'll just click on this one, that is John. So you see what is the difference happen. So if I click here, the John is selected. If I click here Rita, you see the Rita name is selected. What exactly is this slicer? So if you observe, I'll go to this option in the drop down. See this Rita is selected. If I click on this Robert, so Robert is selected here and you see the name is given here. So now if you see the button, it is given here, that's a clear filter. So I'll click on clear. So you get all the options are selected here. Now if you're interested to select more than one option, let's say two options, you can just click on this John and you can just press control from a keyboard and click on this Rita. So you have selected more than one option here. So you see John and Rita which are displayed. Now if you want to go a bit more detail into it, let's say I have only one slicer, this one. This is a slicer. If you want more than one slicer, let's say you want for the region also, again do the same option. I'll just keep my cursor in the data, that's the pivot table, analyze, insert slicer. Now I want the second one, that is the region, and click on OK. So now I have two slices. If you want to easily, or you can say understand what is the sales done of John in the east region. So what you do is select John, right? And you have to select the east region like this one. So John has done a sales in the east region, that is 3017. Similarly, if you want to find out Rita in the east region, if you want Joseph in south region, so this way you can get the answer. So mostly when you go for the presentation, this kind of slices are used a lot instead of going and selecting from the drop down and all the options. Now, but the very thing is, I'll just clear the filter from here, clear the filter from here now, right? Now if you see, it is a bit compact form. You have to again drag it down to understand and find out what are the values present in this slicer. So what you have to do is every time you have to just expand, or you can say minimize. I'll just move it on the right hand side. Yeah, this way. So every time you have to minimize and maximize, change the size of the slicer, you are not able to understand. So what you can do is you can increase or decrease height, width, length, everything from this, you know, slicer. So how you get it? Once you click outside, there is no tools available. So once you click on the slicer, if you see, there's a slicer tools which are available on the top and the options tab is given here. So on the very right hand side, if you see, there's a height and width given here. So how many number of columns you want? So if I click on this above option, you see there are two columns given here. Now the size of the columns is a bit less, you know, this thing is less. So if you want, you can increase the height of this column. So I'll just click on plus sign. That means it is increasing the height. You know, this size is increasing. Similarly, if you want to increase the width, you have to click on this top button here. So the width will increase. So here, like, I'll click on this option like this. Similarly, if you want to increase the height of the slicer, so you have to use this option on the top like this. The height of the slicer will increase. Similarly, if you want to increase the width of the slicer, you have to use this option, which is 9.6, 9.8 and all. So this way you can get it. So slices are more useful, user friendly, and you can put an attachment and you can work on it. Attachment in the sense you can put it nearby somewhere. Next one is, if you want, there are two slices. If you want to change the color, if you get confused which slicer to be used, so you can just click on this slicer style, select any style whichever you like, and you can use it like this. The color changes. Similarly, if you want to change the color for this one, you can change the color. Yeah, this way. So slicers are much more user friendly, right? It's gone. I have to increase the size. Yes. Yeah, this way. So now if you do not want the slicer, the very simple thing is select the slicer and press delete key from your keyboard. The slicer will go away. Now let's see that. Now I have one slicer connected to one table. What if my one slicer is connected to more than one, that is two pivot tables? Let's see how. So what I'll do is, first of all, I'll create two pivot tables. Very simple method to create two pivot tables, or copy paste. So simple thing is, I'll just, yeah, how do I copy paste a pivot table? Keep your cursor in the data, press Ctrl A, Ctrl C, and you can just press here Ctrl V, Ctrl V for paste. And now if you see the magic here, what will happen if I select here from west, you see the west and west is selected from here, right? West and west. If I select south, both the places south and south is selected, east and east is selected. So what I'm trying to say is, your one slice is connected to more than one pivot table, that is two pivot table. Where do I see how many connections are there? So what you have to do is click on the slicer, go to the slicer tools, that is the option, and you can click on that options. You see there's a report connections. In that report connection, it will tell you that your slicer is connected to pivot table 1, pivot table 2. Now what is pivot and pivot 2? I'll close this. This one, and I go to analyze tab, if you see that's a pivot table 1. If I click on this pivot table, what is the name of this pivot table is? You see that's a pivot table 2. So if you want or do not want, you can just remove the connection. I'll click on that, go to options, report connections. If you do not want the connection, just click on this checkbox. That means you're not giving a permission to give it. And you can click on OK. So now only one column will change, or one pivot table will change. If I select here south, you see the south is selected, whereas the other region is not selected. Now the connection has been removed properly. So now, if you want to rename the slicer, right now the name of the slicer is region. If you want to rename it, what you can do is, you can click on this slicer settings, and you see there's a name given. I'll just change the name as region 2 and click on OK. So yeah, so I'll click on the slicer settings. You have to change here in the caption heading. Region 21, let's say, click on OK. So you see the name of the slicer, that's the caption is as changed as region 21. So this way you can work on slicers, and yeah, these are the options where you can align the slicers in a proper format. So I'll just show you how to align. I'll create one more slicer here. So I'll click on analyze, insert slicer and region, and click on OK. Region already I have. I'll create another one, insert slicer. I'll go for the product, click on OK. I'll delete one region because I already have it, right? If I have two slicers, how do I change it? I have to select both of them. Once I click on both of them, what will happen is like this, and I can see whether to bring it forward, to bring it backward, and so on. So right now what I want is, I want to bring this at the back end. Yeah, this slicer, I want to send it to back. So I can click on this option as bring forward or bring to front. So yeah, send backward. I'll say as send backward. So this slicer went back. Similarly, forward and backward are same. And also you can take the help of this selection pane and alignment. What does alignment says is, how do you want to align your slices properly? So I'll select here and go to alignment, and these are the options, left, right, center, middle, wherever you want, you can align the options. And the selection pane, what a selection pane does is, these two are selected. Right now I've selected only one slicer. This is a slicer, that's a product. So on the right hand side, if you see, it says product is selected and it is visible. If you click on this eye, so you see the slicer will go away. If you click on this region 2 slicer I, that means the I symbol, it will go away. If you want to bring it back, you can just click on this sign so that both these slices will come back. So this selection pane is used to hide and show the things required. And if you do not require this slicer, the very simple thing is just select the slicer, delete it, and delete it. So this way you can insert, delete, and play with the slices and rename, you know, alignment, and you can bring in forward and do it different stuff with that. So I hope you have understood. That's all for this video.